Hello, and welcome to this presentation, Understanding Frequency Shift Keying. This presentation provides a technical introduction to frequency shift keying, including basic signal and modulation parameters, as well as a discussion of the main variants of FSK. Frequency shift keying is used to transmit digital information, that is, ones and zeros, by switching a carrier between discrete frequencies. Contrast this with analog frequency modulation, in which the carrier frequency is varied continuously depending on an analog modulating signal. FSK modulation is often broken down into two categories. The simplest scheme uses only two discrete frequencies, and this is called binary FSK or BFSK. There are also FSK schemes that use more than two frequencies, and these are called M-ary FSK. We'll start by looking at the most simple form, BFSK. Binary FSK, or 2FSK, uses two frequencies, the mark, which corresponds to a logical 1, and the space, which corresponds to a logical 0. By convention, the mark is always the higher of the two frequencies. The distance between these two carriers and the nominal center frequency is called the deviation, either F sub D or delta F sub C. This is also called shift, which is where frequency shift keying gets its name. Note also that in BFSK, the bit rate equals the baud rate. In other words, at each so-called symbol interval, we can transmit either a 0 or a 1, that is, one bit. Looking at a time domain representation of FSK, we can clearly see that the amplitude of the carrier does not change. This is a significant advantage in that it simplifies amplifier design and selection. We can still recover the information even if a non-linear amplifier causes amplitude fluctuations in the transmitted or received signal. We can also make a distinction between so-called coherent and non-coherent FSK. If our two BFSK tones are generated by the same oscillator, this is called coherent or continuous FSK. On the other hand, if they're generated by separate oscillators, this is called non-coherent or discontinuous FSK. In the case of non-coherent FSK, the lack of a common oscillator can produce phase discontinuities at the switching points. These can be problematic, since these sharp changes in phase can lead to issues like wider signal bandwidth or bit errors. Non-coherent FSK is, however, cheaper and easier to implement. Note that there are numerous variants of coherent FSK, such as minimum shift keying and Gaussian minimum shift keying. The advantage of these two variants is that they allow closer spacing of the two tones. Let's look at this question of tone spacing in a little bit more detail. An important question in FSK is, how far apart should the mark and space be? More precisely, what value of deviation should we use? If the two tones are too close together, they could interfere with each other, something often called inter-symbol interference. If they're too far apart, this is spectrally inefficient. That is, the signal uses too much bandwidth. So a good place to start would be explaining how we can compute the bandwidth of an FSK signal. Although it might seem that the total bandwidth of an FSK signal is simply twice the frequency deviation, this would be incorrect. The minimum FSK bandwidth is actually a function of both the frequency deviation and the bit rate of the modulating signal. The formula for minimum FSK bandwidth is 2 times the sum of the deviation and the bitrate. Let's use POXAG paging as an example. In this application, the three common bitrates are 512, 1200, or 2400 bits per second, and a typical deviation is 4.5 kHz. If we compute the minimum bandwidth for each of these data rates, we can clearly see that minimum bandwidth increases as the bitrate increases. But we still haven't answered the question about how far apart the tones should be. Again, to minimize the bandwidth of the FSK signal, the tones should be as close to each other as possible without creating inter-symbol interference. We can quantify this using something called the modulation index, which is the ratio of twice the deviation to the bitrate. For example, if we're using a deviation of 20 kHz and the bitrate is 40 kilobits per second, then we have a modulation index of 1.0. If we were to decrease the deviation to only 10 kHz, that is, move the tones closer together, the modulation index would decrease to 0.5. The same thing would happen if we held the tone spacing constant, but doubled the bitrate. Optimal detection of a received FSK signal occurs when the modulation index, H, is greater than 1. So generally, we choose our deviation, and by extension, the space between the tones, for a given bit rate such that H is at least 1. One of the advantages of the coherent FSK schemes we mentioned earlier is that they can properly detect signals even when the modulation index is less than 1. For example, minimum shift keying can detect signals when H is as low as 0.5. This means that MSK needs less bandwidth than standard BFSK to reliably transmit signals at the same bit rate. The most common application for basic binary frequency shift keying is paging. In paging systems, the frequency deviation is large and the data rate is low, making the signals reliable and robust with good signal penetration. For these same reasons, BFSK is also used for things like data collection and remote controls. However, for some of these applications, BFSK is slowly being replaced by other technologies, such as QAM or SOQ-PSK, because these higher order modulation schemes can offer much higher data rates. However, the coherent and/or filtered variants of FSK are still in wide use, including applications such as Bluetooth, DECT, etc. FSK schemes that use more than two frequencies are called M-ary FSK. You may sometimes hear this referred to, slightly imprecisely, as MFSK. The number of tones or the order is always even, so we have 4FSK, 6FSK, 8FSK, etc. Each of these tones or frequencies then represents log 2m bits. For example, in an 8FSK system, m is 8 and each tone is 3 bits. Most of the BFSK formulas in this presentation can easily be adapted to apply to the more generic case of M-ary FSK. M-ary FSK has been used in radio communication systems for decades. One early example from the 1960s was Piccolo, which came in 6FSK and 12FSK variants. Even though Piccolo is now essentially obsolete, it's worth mentioning because the name Piccolo is derived from the musical quality of demodulated M-ary FSK. On the other hand, automatic link establishment, or ALE, is very much alive and well and uses 8FSK. In addition, many modern digital two-way radios use technologies like P25, DMR, and NXDN, which are all based on 4FSK. And as with binary FSK, one of the main reasons for using FSK in these applications is simplicity and robustness. Using higher order M-ary FSK simply enables greater throughput at the cost of wider bandwidth. In summary, frequency shift keying, or FSK, conveys digital data by shifting a carrier between two or more discrete frequencies, with each frequency representing one or more bits. Binary frequency shift keying has only two different frequencies, called mark and space, whereas M-ary FSK uses more than two frequencies. Coherent FSK avoids abrupt phase transitions between states, and this minimizes both the resulting spectral width and bit errors. The minimum bandwidth of an FSK signal and the necessary minimum spacing between the carriers is often determined by the input bit rate, with higher bit rates requiring a wider separation of the tones. FSK is still widely used in many applications. It's robust and allows the use of more efficient nonlinear amplifiers, but tends to have lower overall bit rates than other digital modulation schemes. This concludes our presentation, Understanding Frequency Shift Keying. Thanks for watching.